Welcome to high school basketball coverage on VTV Channel 6. I'm Merlin Rasmussen here with Brandon Jones. We are at Union High School for tonight's matchup between the Lady Cougars and the Stansbury Stallions. The Stansbury Stallions come in, and they're coached by Mackenzie Newton. And in discussing with her, some of her keys to the game was, first of all, transition on defense. What do you think for that, Brandon?
Oh, yeah, definitely when you play defense and you get your hands in the lanes and you get the balls and the steals, then you lead it into a transition, throw the pass to the open layup. And they like to run the team. You know, they like run like deers. So they're kind of undersized. They don't have a lot of height, so they got to make up for it in speed.
And then our next key was boxing out. You always see that with just about every coach, something about rebounding. You got to get a body on people and box them out if you want to win the battle on the boards there. And taking care of the basketball was their third key to the game for the Stallions.
Yeah, the turnovers can kill you, especially on the road when you come to a team here like Union. You know, they have a pretty good crowd and a pretty good stadium here where, you know, you can get nerves, you know, being away. And if you just execute and don't turn over the ball, then you can really establish yourself early.
That's a key to, in most games, is whoever usually wins that turnover margin, no matter what game it is, really, whether it be basketball, whether it be football, usually the winner of the turnover margin wins the game. Starting lineups for the Stallions. Number four will be Mia Thurber. She comes in averaging 5.7 points a game. She's hit 18 three-pointers on the year, so likes to shoot the ball from the outside, looks like.
Yeah, not only that, she has 63 assists on the year, so she passes the ball to open teammates very well.
She'll be joined by number 11, that's Deanna Castillo. And Castillo averages 6.7 points a game, and she's hit 32 three-pointers. Then they'll be joined by Josie Warner, number 21. She's averaging 5.8 points a game. And also number 5, that is Kirsten Item. She's averaging just over 5.5 points a game. And then rounding out the starting five is Taylor Hines. She wears number 15. She averages 7.5 points a game. And she led the Stallions in the game against Union when the Stallions came out victorious 47-44 in that game. She led them with 13 points. Thurber had 10 in that game. And then off the bench, Sienna Riggle had 7. And then Castillo and Warner both chipped in 6. And Idem with 3. And then Phillips with 2 as they came away with a 3-point victory. And this game tonight is very important for both of these teams. The winner of this game will be the second place seed in the first round of the state tournament, and the loser will be the third place seed, if I understand things correctly, according to the Deseret News and the article I read today about the game here tonight between the Stallions and the Lady Cougars.
Yeah, what's also crazy about the Stallions is they have six scorers that scored over 100 points this year. I mean, that is just crazy in high school basketball to have that many on one team, to have that many points.
Especially in high school girls basketball.
For the year.
That is very impressive. And like I say, they came away with a 3-point victory in their first meeting. That meeting was back on January 24th out in Stansbury. So, starting for the Cougars, we didn't get any information on some keys to the game from Coach Hoops, but I would imagine it'd be very similar to what Coach McKenzie had for the Stallions. Win the turnover margin and win the battle of the boards. The starters for the Lady Cougars, number 5, Tori Ross, she comes in averaging 9.5 points a game. She's hit 24 three-pointers on the year. She'll be joined by number 10, Kennedy Ross, who averages 7 points a game. She's got 14 threes on the year. Then Marley Horrocks averages 5 points a game. And number 14 is Reagan Anderson. She averages 8. And the number 15, Carly Blake, will be the final starter, and she averages 9 points a game. So pretty balanced scoring for the Lady Cougars. And in that game against the Stallions. Torrey Ross led all scorers with 14. Blake had 9, as did Horrocks. And then Kennedy Ross chipped in 6 and 4. And Ellison Weaver came off the bench and scored a bucket at the Lady Cougars. Looks like we're getting ready for the flag ceremony, so we'll go ahead and take a quick break.
Service to its customers for over 75 years. With a state-of-the-art electrical system, we are setting a standard for excellence in the electric utility industry. We are proud to call this place home, and we are happy to support our local schools and athletes. Find and like us on Facebook for energy-saving tips. Moon Lake Electric, keeping the power on.
On the current episode of Wild Air, Blake Finn takes us along on its archery deer hunt. Then we follow the DWR as they release some turkeys in the Brook Cliffs. All of this on the latest episode of Wild Air. Founded in 1946 by the Savage family with a single truck, today, Savage is the leader in supply chain management solutions that are tailored to meet the needs of our customers across a variety of industries. We are a proud sponsor of high school sports coverage and the community here in the Uinta Basin.
All right, welcome back to Union High School. Lady Cougar basketball here on VTV. We are getting ready for the starting lineups. We went over those with you just a few minutes ago. Before we get started here, Brandon, any thoughts on how do you think tonight's going to turn out?
You know, I like to bring up what you said about balance. Both these teams look really balanced. You know, there's a lot of scoring, but a lot of scoring from individual players, a lot of players. And on, you know, on the side of Union, you know, Torrey Ross, she's, you know, your point guard, your floor leader, but she can score too. And so you watch for her to make big plays. And then Carly Blake, she is just absolutely awesome in making jump shots and just moving around without the ball and getting shots wide open. So look for her to do that. And then on the other side, you know, Mia Thurber with the assist and given, you know, when you make that extra pass and get it a team wide open, a player wide open, it's just, it makes it so easy to get it in the hoop. And so you'll see a high scoring Stallions team. And then you have your leading scorer, Taylor Hines, watch for her. You know, she doesn't get a lot of threes, but she gets underneath, and they don't have a lot of height, but she's kind of their center or power forward, if you like, and she gets it done. So a very balanced both teams, and both like to run and get in transition. So this is going to be exciting.
You know, and as we mentioned, it's senior night, but the Lady Cougars don't have any seniors. They're all underclassmen. So really that distraction is out of the way. When I coached, senior night, homecoming, those types of games were tough to get teams. They were up for them, but oftentimes they were too up for them, and it took a quarter or so to get things settled back down. But the Lady Cougars shouldn't have to worry about that tonight. They should be able to just come out and get after it right from the beginning. So last home game, again, playoffs on the line. You couldn't ask for anything more. Both these teams know they're going to go to the playoff. It's just a matter of where they're going to go and who they're going to play in that next round. So look for a good game tonight, good battle.
And that's a good point that you brought up with, you know, it's no seniors, no pressure. I mean, when you're a senior, you're going to see the floor the last time, emotions get to you, and it usually takes you about a quarter to get back into it. And I played football. I remember my last day on the field and very emotional and hard to really get in sync to playing that first quarter. So they don't have to worry about that. So we can just get, go game on, right?
Yeah, and that's what we're about to do, about to get things started. We'll see. Looks like that's going to be Anderson in the middle for the Lady Cougars, and Hines will jump for the Stallions. And we are ready to go. First quarter action, ball up. Going to be knocked around and out of bounds. It's going to be Cougar ball.
And we'll see if they get Reagan Anderson involved early, just because of the heights disparity on that side of the Stallions. They could probably get her established.
Tori's going to bring it across. She'll go to Kennedy. That's Ross. Two Rosses on the court for the Cougars. Now she's going to go inside. That looks like that's Blake. And she's going to go up and be fouled. The yellow numbers on the white make it difficult to see. But that is indeed number 12, Blake. She will be shooting.
And that's what Blake does. She just gets underneath there, wide open, gets two guys on her, knows she's smart enough to have those two people on her, and she just gets the foul.
Hits the first free throw. I said 12, it's actually 15. Second free throw miss, gonna be brought down by the Stallions. And they're gonna push it across. That's number 4, Thurber, with the ball. Thurber's gonna back it out, guarded by Ross. She'll now go to Castillo. Castillo looks, goes, swings it over to Item. Item yo-yos the dribble out top. She picks it up, goes over to Hines. Hines drives, now kicks it back out by to Castillo. Castillo off to Item. Item's shot is long, no good. Gonna be rebounded there by the Lady Cougars. Quickly, they get it off to Ross. Ross pulls up, goes over to Ross, three-pointer up and no good by Kennedy Ross. However, offensive rebound there by the Lady Cougars. That was Horrocks. Her shot is missed and no good. The Stallions will push it. That's going to be out to Item. She'll fire up a three-pointer off, no good. Rebound there by Anderson. And she'll hand to Ross.
An up and down pace game already, Merlin. It's just they're here and ready to go. We don't have a lot of scores on the board, but Reagan Anderson tries to get it up there, but Carly Blake's fouled again.
She's going to be fouled again and go to the free throw line. That foul was, I think it was Thurber. I haven't put him up on the board, so Blake will be shooting two. She's one of two. And that is up and good.
And a lot of talent on this young Union Cougar squad. I mean, they're, most of them are only freshmen and sophomores, a few juniors. They just have a lot of room to grow, and man, they're going to be really good in the next coming years.
Second free throw good, makes it a 3-0 game, 6:35 here in the first quarter. Pressure being applied by the Lady Cougars, and finally they will get it across. That is Warner. Warner holds the dribble out high. She goes to Hines. Hines goes now to Item. Item working on the right wing, gets it inside. That is Hines. Her shot is up and no good. Rebound by the Lady Cougars. Quickly, Ross pushing it once again. Has it knocked away. She's able to regain control. She's going to fire up a three-pointer. It's long and good. Tori Ross for three. It's a 6-0 score early on here in the first quarter.
Really good shot there by Tori. She just pulls up from three after like dribbling the ball kind of off her knees. She just stays in control, shoots it up, nails the three.
Item will now drive and kick out to Warner. Warner's going to drive and put a shot up. She's fouled.
Marley thought she was straight up, but the refs call it differently.
It's on Horrocks. That'll be her first. It'll be down, so the Stallions will be inbounding. Looks like Warner set the inbound.
It's one thing the Unions really do well on defense. They get right in the face of their defender, of their opposer.
Thurber tries to work off a screen. Ross did a nice job of going over the top. Now that is cross court, stolen away by Ross. She's going to drive and put it up with the left hand. Missed, but a nice rebound there by Blake. And up and in for an early 8-0 lead by the Lady Cougars. And that'll bring A timeout call from the Stallions gives us a moment to thank our fine sponsors. We've got L&L Motor. They want to remind you that it's the love of the game, the players, the competition, and the diehard fans that matter most. Let each mile you drive in your L&L vehicle take you to the moments that matter most in your life. That's L&L Motor, one of our many fine sponsors of high school basketball here on BTV.
That was a good timeout there by the Stallions there, and I think they just need to, you know, get their legs underneath them, and I think the coach is going to be talking to them, just calm down, you know, make the extra pass. You know, the defense is a little bit tough right now. Make that extra pass, and that they won't be right there. So I think that's just what she's doing there.
She also spent a little time lobbying to one of the officials, which coaches do during timeouts. And this is going to be Thurber who will bring it across. She will now go to Castile. Hands off to Warner. Warner drives, puts the shot up, and scores. Josie Warner makes it an 8-2 game. Ross quickly delivers out to Blake. She'll fire up from the baseline. It is up and good. Carly Blake with her 7th point of the game, leading the Cougars in scoring here. Item Gow goes off to Hines. Hines bump, gives it off to Warner, out to Castillo. And she has it knocked away. She regains control, goes to Warner just outside the free throw line. No good. Anderson on the rebound. Cougars going to slow it down just a little bit.
And Carly Blake, you know, she's just all over the place. Like I said, what she does without the ball is amazing. She just gets open, runs around until she gets a shot, and that's what happened there.
Three-pointer fired up there by Kennedy Ross. No good. Rebounded by the Stallions. Thurber will get it over to Castillo. Now back to Thurber. Good defense there by Ross. Warner now has the ball out top. She will drive, kick it off to Hines, and back to Castillo. Long three-pointer off the rim. Rebound by the Lady Stallions, and Item misses a shot. Ross comes away with the rebound. And Torrey will push, little crossover floater, no good. However, rebounded right there by, that is Horrocks. And Marley able to put it back in, a 12-2 lead for the Lady Cougars. Thurber works to Warner. Warner kicks it off to Castillo. Now inside. That was Hines who goes up and is going to be fouled.
Two really good offensive rebounds by Union on the other side. Carly Blake and Marley Horrocks working. And I think you said with the nerves, there is no nerves on senior night because there's no seniors. And they've just got right into this game and have no jitters. And you see that Stansbury, they're starting to get into it. After that timeout, they got 2 points right away. I think it was a good call by the coach. Just drive in, penetrate, get some penetration underneath the rim, and that's what they're trying to do. So,
see Hines with one more. She hit the first. Number two, Casey Phillips, has checked in for the Stallions. Hines' second free throw up and good as well. Now they're going to put a little pressure on, and the Lady Cougars are able to get it across. It's going to be Blake holding out high. She'll go cross court. Now back to Ross. Torrey working here in the middle, pressure being applied. She crossover dribble, gets it to Blake, and her shot, or that was Horrocks, excuse me, and no good. Rebound there by Castillo. She goes off to Thurber. 2:29 to go here in the first quarter. Thurber's pass to Phillips. Now to Warner, she drives, puts the shot up and in. Josie Warner with a nice drive.
That's the second drive that she had, just going up with two people on her. Doesn't care, just needs to get points for her team.
Three-pointer missed, however, chased down by Blake. Now a cross-court pass, going to be knocked away, but Ross able to control, and she kicks it off to Anderson. Anderson's shot is up and good.
If they could get that shot to go every time with Reagan Anderson moving out to about the mid-range free throw line, that would be huge. I mean, she's underneath all the time making scores, but like those kind of shots don't go up quite as many times.
Warner puts up a long shot. It's no good. Rebound going to be finally after being knocked away. Ross comes away with it. She'll pass to...
It's Carly Blake.
And shot no good. Rebound there by Castillo.
Kennedy Ross.
These numbers, as we mentioned, are kind of difficult to see. Warner again inside. Shot is up and good. Josie Warner with 6 of the Stallions' 8 points. And we're going to have a foul there. Looks like number 11, Castillo.
And that's the third drive in by Warner. And you want to see if Hoops on the other side will maybe try to double team her, get her so that she can't come in. Do some things that they're going to talk about in this timeout. So
timeout here. We'll go ahead and send it back to the station for a quick break.
Service to its customers for over 75 years. With a state-of-the-art electrical system, we are setting a standard for excellence in the electric utility industry. We are proud to call this place home, and we are happy to support our local schools and athletes. Find and like us on Facebook for energy-saving tips. Moon Lake Electric, keeping the power on.
All right, we're back. First quarter action, 1:15. Remaining in the first quarter, the Lady Cougars 14, the Stallions of Stansbury 8. And it'll be the Lady Cougars 2 inbound. They go to Tori Ross. Tori dribbles way out high, calls the play, now goes over to Kennedy. She gets it inside to number 33, that's Ellison Weaver that has checked in. We're gonna have a jump ball.
Yeah, you can see they wanted to kick it right back out to Kennedy Ross, but the double team right there in a trap, she couldn't get it out. To her credit, the defense of Stansbury there.
Item back in for the Stallions. That's Thurber with the ball. She'll dribble out top, works off of a screen, now kicks it out to Phillips. Her three-pointer is no good, and rebound there by Weaver. Weaver gets it off to Ross. Ross will go over to Kennedy Ross. She'll fire up a three-pointer. This one's good.
The game plan worked that time. They got it to Kennedy Ross on this right side corner. Nails it like every day she does that. She'll shoot 100 a day of those.
Pressure coming from the Cougars. The Stallions able to get it down inside to Warner. And a nice rebound there by the Stallions, but no good on the second shot, and we're going to have a foul. I think that's Warner, 21. So now the Stallions will apply some full court pressure. And they'll get it in. Quickly to Ross. Now a nice bounce pass inside. Shot is up, missed, no good. Batted around, and finally Thurber comes away with it for the Stallions. Quickly goes to Phillips. Phillips throws up a left-handed shot as time expires. And at the end of one, it's a 9-point lead for the Lady Cougars, 17-8. We'll be back for second quarter action.
Dr. Carl Breitenbach, Dr. Rod Anderson, Dr. John Griffith, Dr. Daniel Kwok, and Dr. Ethan Pettit, all part of the great team for obstetric and newborn care at Ashley Regional Medical Center. Our obstetric team has over 80 years of combined experience in delivering your baby and working closely with a highly trained team of obstetrical nurses. Our pediatrics team can treat newborns at 34 weeks and older in our Level 2 NICU, providing you with the opportunity to stay close to home with your friends and family to support you. Our new Women's Center, opening in 2018, will provide the latest in amenities for your comfort and quality of care. Worried about costs? Our new Storks program can provide you with the help you may need. You can ask any of our providers for more information. You can trust the care at Ashley Regional for you and your newborn. Ashley Regional, making communities healthier.
We are back. Second quarter action just about to get underway. The Lady Cougars will inbound. And it's going to be Ross with the ball. As Lindy Miller inbounded for the Cougars to Ross. Ross being guarded there by Thurber. And she's able to get it off to Miller. Miller able to go to Horrocks. Horrocks now off to Ross. Three-pointer fired up off the top of the backboard. It'll be Stallion ball.
Really good defense there by Mia Thurber. Right there in the passing lane. All over Tori Ross. That's hard to do because she's a really good point guard and she can really dribble around. She's got the handles. So that was really good defense. And there's a drive-in shot.
Thurber shot no good. Ross comes away with it. And Ross will bring it down. She'll go off to Miller now. Miller looks inside. Nice pass inside. Shot is missed, but Blake is going to be fouled. You don't see an entry pass like that in girls high school basketball very often. That was well placed right into Blake's hands.
Yeah, that was a great interior pass. And then she sealed her girl too, and so that she could get it wide open. That just got the foul. What a great play there by both players.
So Blake, who is 3 of 4 from the line, will have 2. And she hits the first. 8 points so far for Carly Blake. She'll shoot one more. And her second shot is up, and it is good as well. Extends the lead to 19-8. Now pressure being applied here by the Lady Cougars. Thurber gets it across. She will work off of a screen by Item. Now she's going to work off of another screen. Good defense there by Miller. Item now with the ball on the wing. Entry pass inside, knocked away. And back out to Item. Her shot is up, bouncing around the rim and in. Touched every part of that rim. Finally got her in.
And those are the shots you like to see on the road when they bounce, 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 and go in. That means the next one's going to go in, too.
Horrocks presses the shot quickly down the floor, puts it up, no good. Phillips is now going to come coast to coast for the Stallions and score.
A little bit of crossover at the end, too, and a little style. Like it.
Nice pass there by Ross, but an even better defensive play. So, but she saves it out to the Cougars. Now a three-pointer fired up, offensive rebound, and we're going to have a timeout here by Coach Hoops. Give us a chance to talk a little bit about Strata Networks, a proud sponsor to help bring you live coverage of local sports. Enjoy reliable coverage and unbeatable speeds from the company that brings you more local cell sites than any other carrier, nationwide 4G LTE coverage, and the latest devices from your favorite brands. Strata Networks is proud to be your local wireless provider. Right now, get a 4G smartphone for zero down and upgrade in as little as 1 year with Strata Plus. Learn more at stratanetworks.com.
So 4 straight points for Stansbury. Great timeout by Hoops. He doesn't want him to get going at all. But also good plays there by Stansbury. Getting the easy ones and a great crossover.
Miller goes inside, that's Anderson, and her shot is going to be up and good. Reagan Anderson.
I'm starting to see the speed of Stansbury. They are all fast. I mean, it's just crazy how quick they are.
Ida misses a shot. Weaver comes away with it.
It's like 5 Tori Rosses out there.
Yeah, exactly. Miller now holds high for the Cougars. She goes inside to Anderson. Anderson cut off. She'll go outside to Kennedy Ross. Three-pointer good. Nice ball movement by the Lady Cougars.
Kennedy Ross with 2 3-pointers early. What a great start for her.
Hines will put the shot up. She's going to be fouled from behind. think they're going to call that on Ross. We'll see. So Hines is going to go to the line to shoot a couple. She's 2 of 2 so far tonight from the charity stripe. And her first one is up. And off the rim, no good. She will have one more. 5:36 to go. It's a 12-point lead, 24-12 for the Lady Cougars. Second shot is up and good for Hines. Quickly into Ross, now to Miller. Miller gets it across the timeline. Nice pass inside. That's Weaver, and she will score. Ellison Weaver.
Yeah, that was a great pass by Miller. Seeing the wide open girl underneath, throwing it right to her on her back shoulder.
Nice block there, and then a foul on the Salyans as Ross blocked it, and Item then fouls her.
Yeah, there's a lot of speed on Stansbury's side, but on Union, they're a lot tougher. They're physical. And I'm wondering if they can handle the physical play that Union brings. And that'll be interesting to see as we go all game long.
I've been impressed with how Union's been able to handle the trap and the pressure that they've applied. Anderson gets her own rebound and puts the shot up. No good. She fights after it. They're all three on the ground. And finally, we're going to have a timeout by the Stallions. It's going to be a full timeout. So we'll go ahead and go back for a quick break.
On the current episode of Wild Air, Blake Finn takes us along on its archery deer hunt. Then we follow the DWR as they release some turkeys in the Brook Cliffs. All of this on the latest episode of Wild Air. Founded in 1946 by the Savage family with a single truck, today Savage is the leader in supply chain management solutions that are tailored to meet the needs of our customers across a variety of industries. We are a proud sponsor of high school sports coverage and the community here in the Uinta Basin.
All right, we're back. Second quarter, 5 minutes and 2 seconds to go. The Lady Cougars 26, the Stallions of Stansbury 13. And they will inbound. It'll be Thurber with the ball. She's still working in the backcourt as Miller will guard her. She now gets it across, goes to Castile. She will work off of a screen. Now bounce pass across to Thurber. Thurber is going to drive and be cut off, but put it up with the left hand. Nice move there by Thurber. Gets the left-handed layup to go. Cougars wasting no time. Get it across quickly. Miller with the dribble. She will go to Weaver. Weaver cross court to Ross. Now back to Anderson. Anderson's shot is up and good.
That's a good-looking shot. She took 2 steps in, shot it. You know, you don't want to take that too deep out, but she put it right in the perfect spot. That's her spot right there, 3 feet from the basket or underneath.
We're going to have an offensive foul here against the Stallions.
You know, usually with young teams, you see defenses lapses or, you know, it's hard to teach the defense. And I think Union has they have that defense that they play. They play really well. Their execution is crazy good. So, I mean, I'm just impressed with the youth and of what they can do and how they will be in the future.
Yeah, I was just thinking that same thing. As young as they are, they keep together and keep working. They're going to be right there. However, Thurber comes away with the steal as Warner knocked it away. Now inside entry pass to, that is number 10. That is Sienna Riggle. She will score her first basket of the game.
Riggle got that wide open, so good shot by her. Those are the ones that are tough to make when you're wide open.
Nice pass inside to Anderson. Her shot is up off the rim, no good. Weaver fighting for the ball, comes away with the rebound.
Look at the determination on that, man. Wow.
You don't see a lot of freshmen do that. That'll be Warner that'll bring it across for the Stallions. And she's going to go into Riggle. Riggle throws a shot up, but they're going to call a foul. Got the L&L motor replay here. Looks like that's going to be on Anderson. She kind of hooked her with that knee.
Yeah, she was kind of lost in low man's land there, and she tried to get the foul the best she could, and she did a good job doing that.
Yep. So they got her before the shot, so Stansbury will just be inbounding underneath their basket. They'll go into Thurber. Thurber goes out to Item. Her three-pointer no good. No, excuse me, that was Castillo. It'll be Miller that'll bring it down. Quickly goes to Weaver. Shot up. No good. Weaver gets it back. And there's going to be a jump ball as Weaver just took it away from Warner. And Warner was able to tie her up. It'll be Stansbury ball.
Another great interior pass, though, by Seneca Miller there. And then the toughness of Weaver. I'm just super impressed. She's like, give me that ball.
She wants the ball. Back to Thurber. They get her trapped in the corner. She's able to get out. And a nice pass inside to Riggle. Riggle will put the shot up. No good. Bat it around. And Warner comes away with it and will score her eighth point. Miller will drive all the way, and she's going to be called for a charge.
Yeah, she was definitely set there. I don't know if we have a replay on that, but looked like she just forced that one in there. But you can't blame her. She's just being, you know, you want to make that play.
Yeah.
You know, you just want to come down and make a layup, and she just didn't get it quite go because that was a good defensive play also to stand in front of her.
Thurber will bring it across. Goes to Castillo. Now down inside to Riggle. Riggle with the shot up. It's off the rim. No good. Offensive rebound by Warner, but she's going to be tied up by Horick. And it'll be Lady Cougar ball. They will get it into Ross. That's now to Blake, I believe, and knocked out of bounds by the Stallions. Kennedy Ross set to inbound.
Lindy Miller is just a sophomore too, and she's really looking good at that point guard position as well. I bet she could run the two.
Mm-hmm. Good guards out there for sure. Oh, Ross close to
saves
the half
it.
Court line, but saves it. Horrocks will now drive, put the shot up. No good. However, offensive rebound by Miller inside with the big people. She puts it up again, and it's going to go off of the Lady Cougars. It'll be out of bounds to Stansbury. 1:45 to go here in the second quarter. Lady Cougars lead by 11.
You got to like the offensive rebound on Union, though. I'm sure the Coach Hoops is proud of that. Even though the shot didn't go in, they got three or four chances at the rim right there.
Well, second chance opportunities, that's a big thing. We got a little conference going on here. I don't know if Warner might have some blood or something. Looks like they're looking at to wrap up. But why they do that gives us a chance to talk a little about Ashley Regional, making communities healthier. Dr. Burke Young and Dr. Adam Mattson providing orthopedic care at Ashley Regional. If you need a family physician, visit the website, ashleyregional.com, for a full list of all the physicians. Thurber gets it across the timeline. She's guarded closely there by Miller. Works off of a screen. Now she'll drive and put the shot up. Blake comes away with a strong rebound, quickly gets it to Ross. Ross will drive. She's now going to pull it out and go to Blake. Blake will hand back off to Ross. Ross has set the play once again. And yo-yos that dribble, goes to Horrocks. Horrocks goes back to Miller. Miller now to Horrocks. Horrocks working on the wing here, trying to get it inside to Blake. And she'll go across court to Miller. Miller will now cross him up and put the shot up herself. Rebounded there by Blake, and her shot is up and in. Carly Blake with a nice shot, working off the rebound.
Stansbury switched it up on defense there, went man-to-man, played it really good, you know, and Union still just passed it around and came up with the shot.
A rebound there by the Lady Cougars. They'll get it out to Ross. On the missed shot, Ross will fire up a three-pointer. It is off the rim, no good. The ball knocked away there by Kennedy Ross. However, Phillips will come away with it for the Stallions. Now Riggle works the free throw line. She goes out to Castillo. Castillo cut off as she dribbles. Phillips, Thurber, and Castillo fires it up from the corner. No good. Offensive rebound by Phillips is no good. And Blake is going to come away with the rebound. She gets tied up by Warner. So it'll be Stallion ball with just 3.8 seconds to go here in the first half.
And Stansbury did a good job of there getting offensive rebounds and putbacks too, but just didn't get it to go in. But man, you got to like the shots and the attempts.
Thurber's shot is up, no good. Phillips with an offensive rebound.
Almost close.
It just about went. So your halftime score, the Lady Cougars 32, Stansbury Stallions 19. We'll go ahead and take a break and then be back with some halftime statistics.
Service to its customers for over 75 years. With a state-of-the-art electrical system, we are setting a standard for excellence in the electric utility industry. We are proud to call this place home, and we are happy to support our local schools and athletes. Find and like us on Facebook for energy-saving tips. Moon Lake Electric, keeping the power on.
Dr. Carl Breitenbach, Dr. Rod Anderson, Dr. John Griffith, Dr. Daniel Kwok, and Dr. Ethan Pettit, all part of the great team for obstetric and newborn care at Ashley Regional Medical Center. Our obstetric team has over 80 years of combined experience in delivering your baby and working closely with a highly trained team of obstetrical nurses. Our pediatrics team can treat newborns at 34 weeks and older in our Level 2 NICU, providing you with the opportunity to stay close to home with your friends and family to support you. Our new Women's Center, opening in 2018, will provide the latest in amenities for your comfort and quality of care. Worried about costs? Our new Storks program can provide you with the help you may need. You can ask any of our providers for more information. You can trust the care at Ashley Regional for you and your newborn. Ashley Regional, making communities healthier.
On the current episode of Wild Air, Blake Finn takes us along on its archery deer hunt. Then we follow the DWR as they release some turkeys in the Brook Cliffs. All of this on the latest episode of Wild Air. Founded in 1946 by the Savage family with a single truck, today Savage is the leader in supply chain management solutions that are tailored to meet the needs of our customers across a variety of industries. We are a proud sponsor of high school sports coverage and the community here in the Uinta Basin.
locally owned cooperative with a deep history of providing dependable and affordable electric service to its customers for over 75 years. With a state-of-the-art electrical system, we are setting a standard for excellence in the electric utility industry. We are proud to call this place home, and we are happy to support our local schools and athletes. Find and like us on Facebook for energy-saving tips. Moon Lake Electric, keeping the power on.
Dr. Carl Breitenbach, Dr. Rod Anderson, Dr. John Griffith, Dr. Daniel Kwok, and Dr. Ethan Pettit, all part of the great team for obstetric and newborn care at Ashley Regional Medical Center. Our obstetric team has over 80 years of combined experience in delivering your baby and working closely with a highly trained team of obstetrical nurses. Our pediatrics team can treat newborns at 34 weeks and older in our Level 2 NICU, providing you with the opportunity to stay close to home with your friends and family to support you. Our new Women's Center, opening in 2018, will provide the latest in amenities for your comfort and quality of care. Worried about costs? Our new Storks program can provide you with the help you may need. You can ask any of our providers for more information. You can trust the care at Ashley Regional for you and your newborn. Ashley Regional, making communities healthier.
All right, we are back. Going to have some halftime highlights here as we have a 32-19 score. The Lady Cougars lead. And we'll look at a few highlights from the first half on the L&L Motor replay. Got a Warner layup here for the Lady Stallions. She drives and able to put that up and in. She did that a couple of times. It's going to be Anderson with a nice little jumper for the Lady Cougars. And there goes Ross for a triple. That is Kennedy Ross. There's Phillips with a nice crossover drive, finishes with her left hand. And there's a nice block, good defense there by Kennedy Ross, putting it back as into the Stallion player as she tried to finish there. What are your thoughts about the first half, Brandon?
I think Unions came out to play, and I think Stansbury is just a little lost in their offense. Shots aren't going in, and sometimes you see that when you get on the road. You know, Twilla's pretty far away. And they just haven't established that shot. So in the second half, I think that their shots will start to go and fall in a little bit more. But I think Union is, I think they're growing as a team. I think last game that they played was against Twilla. Twilla's a pretty good team, and they won 47-31. So they kind of use that as a springboard of playing really well lately. And I think that that's just going to lead into their being really good next year. So, and then, you know, with Kennedy Ross, she's 2-for-3 at the three-point line. That's huge in girls' games to swing a six-point lead like that with two threes.
Scorers for the Stallions, leading them is number 21, Josie Warner. She has 8 points. We saw a couple of those quick little layups that she got early in the first half. She scored everything inside. She has 8. Taylor Hines has 3. Those have all come from the free throw line. And then Riggle has a basket, as does Kirsten Item. And Mia Thurber has 2, and then Kaylee Phillips that we saw as well has 2 points for the Stallions for their 19 points. Leading the way for the Lady Cougars, and most of her damage was done early on in that first quarter. Setting the tone was Carly Blake. She finishes the first half with 11 points and scored 9 of those in that first quarter. Then she's followed by Kennedy Ross with 6 points, both of them off three-pointers. And then Reagan Anderson has 6 points on 3 baskets. 4 points out of Ellison Weaver off the bench, and she's done a nice job just grabbing a hold of the ball and saying, it's my ball, I'm taking it.
I'm impressed by the toughness of Weaver and Carly Blake and who's the other one, Kennedy Ross. Both of them are all just getting into the face of Stansbury and not letting them go. And, and when there's a ball opportunity, they're grabbing it and just ripping it away. You like to see that physicality. And it's kind of making Stansbury take a step back. It'll be interesting to see if the coach in halftime says, hey, we have to play physical because they are. And you know, I think that they'll do that. But I think the biggest thing with Stansbury is they need to make shots. I mean, they're used to scoring lots of points. And when you have one guy off or one girl off, then, you know, the other one will score. And they have 5 scorers that have scored 100. there's going to be some scoring in the second half for sure. They're going to come back. This isn't a lead that's safe.
Exactly. Torrey Ross also hit a three-pointer, and then Marley Horrocks had a quick basket for the 32 points for the Lady Cougars. Well, we'll go ahead and go back for a break, and then we'll get ready for some third quarter action.
On the current episode of Wild Air, Blake Finn takes us along on its archery deer hunt. Then we follow the DWR as they release some turkeys in the Brook Cliffs. All of this on the latest episode of Wild Air. Founded in 1946 by the Savage family with a single truck, today, Savage is the leader in supply chain management solutions that are tailored to meet the needs of our customers across a variety of industries. We are a proud sponsor of high school sports coverage and the community here in the Uinta Basin.
That is going to be Anderson. She holds top of the circle, goes to Ross. Ross will fake back to Ross, kicked out of bounds, and they're going to say off of the Stansbury Stallions. It'll be Lady Cougar ball. Horrick set to inbounds. She lobs to Anderson. Anderson crossover and a shot up. Contact, no foul, but Horrick's able to get the offensive rebound, and she will put it in for two. Thurber will bring it across for the Stansbury Stallions. That is going to be Hines working inside. She will spin, fired up, missed it. Warner is gonna make the shot and gonna be fouled. So she'll go to the free throw line, possible 3-point play here. Looks like that foul was on Blake.
Josie Warner, she's having a really great game so far. Every time that Stansbury's needed a shot, she's got in the lane, either got fouled or got the layup to go, even with defenders in her face. So what a great play by her.
Missed the free throw, though. Blake come away with a strong rebound. Now Horrocks has got the ball out high for the Cougars. She'll go to Ross. Torrey working on the left wing. She'll go to Kennedy on out top, now all the way over to Horrocks. Horrocks looking now. She will dribble and come out top. Now she crosses over on, goes back to Blake. It's knocked away, but Carly able to get the ball and regain control. Ross now working. She will drive and all the way to the basket. Shot no good, however. And Item comes away with the rebound for Stansbury. Again, it's Warner. Fires up the left-handed shot inside. No good. Blake, when Blake rebounds, those elbows get out. She definitely lets people know that she is in charge. There's a shot up by Carly Blake, no good. And rebounded by Thurber. Thurber gets it ahead underneath the basket. Tough shot by Hines as it hits the bottom of the basket. Now an outlet pass gets away from Ross, but she's quickly able to regain control.
Yeah, she just didn't realize where she was at underneath the basket. Could have kicked it out for three or even to someone that was a trailer coming in.
Inside to Weaver. Now kicks it out. And a three-pointer up by Horrocks is long. However, right there, Johnny on the spot is Blake.
Carly Blake.
And she'll put it up and in, and she will be fouled.
You know, I've seen a couple games now with Carly Blake, and her hustle is just crazy. And she, like I said, she moves so well without the ball, but then when she has the ball, she knows exactly what to do with it. So just great play by her.
Foul on Hines, that's her third. Blake will be at the free throw line to shoot one. And it is long, no good. Rebound there by Stansbury. They'll go to Phillips, now to Warner. Thurber quickly to Item. Back out to Warner. Warner looks. Picks up the dribble, goes cross court to Thurber. She'll fire up a three-pointer, long, no good. Rebound there by Kennedy Ross. She'll hand it off to Carly. To Torrey. Corey's going to get it to Horrocks, and Horrocks will drive, loses it out of bounds. It'll be a turnover.
The first half, you know, Stansbury, they went to that man-to-man defense, and it started working for them, even though Union got a couple shots off it. This second half, they've gone right back to it. And then they got a turnover right there, so it's worked.
Switching it up there for the Stallions. Thurber will go to Phillips. Phillips going to hand off to Warner. Warner spins, pivots, throws up a shot, no good, follows it, gets her own rebound, and knocked away. Finally, Ross is going to gain control, and Ross will spin and have it knocked away. She's going to regain control, goes to Horrocks. Now back to Ross, over to Kennedy Ross. She will drive, go to Weaver. Weaver will go cross court to Horrocks. She'll fire up a three-pointer. It's no good. And Item comes away with the rebound. She's going to push it. She has Hines, and just a little too far out in front of Hines, out of bounds.
And that's really too bad for Stansbury. They've had a couple stops in a row. Union is not as hot as they were in the first half. They need to capitalize on those type of plays. They're wide open.
Miller will replace Horrocks for the Lady Cougars. Ross brings it across, and she'll go to Kennedy. Kennedy fires inside, knocked away from Weaver, going to be picked up by Phillips. And then we'll go back to Phillips now. She'll work off of a screen, and she'll pass into Thurber. That's knocked away by Kennedy Ross. Finally, Miller comes away with it. Miller's going to push, and she's got Blake. And Blake's going to be knocked down hard. It'll be a foul. I believe that's going to be four on Hines.
Pretty hard foul on there on the replay. We'll see. She just was trying to stay straight up, but she got into the body there a little bit. But it wasn't as hard as I thought it was.
Yeah, it looked a lot worse than in that replay. Blake's 5 of 7 from the free throw line. She'll shoot a couple more. And the first is up and good. Horrocks is going to replace Tori Ross. Blake will shoot one more.
And if you're Stansbury, you know, you want to get some shots on the other side. You want to get this within single digits so they don't pull away on you, especially on the road. Just a few points matters, so they have to get a good possession here. Don't turn over the ball. Get a good shot. Give it to your best person.
Halfway through the third quarter here, the Cougars have extended the lead out to 17 as a shot is up by Phillips.
Good looking shot on the elbow of the free throw line there. I love that shot. That's my favorite shot.
Ross will fire up a three-pointer just long off the rim. Good offensive rebound by Horrocks. She's then going to be tied up, and it'll be Stansbury ball. That shot by Ross looked good. Just hit the back iron. Came out, so 3:30 to go in the third quarter. Stansbury will bring it across. That's Thurber. She's guarded by Miller. Pressure man-to-man defense being played by the Cougars. They'll go to Phillips. Phillips works now back out to Thurber. Miller there hounding her. Nice move inside to Hines. She lost control but was able to regain and get the basket to go. Quickly down to Blake. Her shot is up and good.
Two really good plays in a row right there. One by Stansbury, one by Union. Carly Blake with the nice shot. But then a great pass by Mia Thurber, and that's what she does best. Throws it right into the interior, wide open. There's another shot that is going to go in.
Hines, two baskets in a row. Horrocks will hand back to Miller. Miller being guarded there by Phillips. She'll drive to the basket, put the shot up and in.
Wow, one-on-one basketball there. Takes her to the hole, makes it, puts it in.
Lindy Miller with the basket.
That was impressive.
Thurber. She'll go to Warner. Warner has it knocked away, but she gets it back. And looks finally gets Thurber three-pointer from the baseline off the top of the rim. And it'll be Lady Cougar ball. Anderson gonna check back in, and she will replace Weaver for the Lady Cougars. Stansbury going to apply some full court pressure.
See if they do just a soft press or a hard press. Might be a little too early for a hard press, but we'll see.
They get it into Blake, now back to Horrocks, and Horrocks is gonna be able to get it across. She'll quickly come across and spins, fires a shot up, no good. And we're gonna have a jump ball. It'll stay with the Cougars. Checking in for the first time for Stansbury is Mackenzie Sargent.
The replay, you can see that she's just, there's just tie up in the top. She wants a foul there, but it's just a tie up.
Ross will come back in for Horrocks. Coach Hoops effectively using that bench he has. Now off to Miller. Miller not even being guarded. Finally, she's picked up. Ross will now work. And Ross will kick it off to Carly Blake.
Carly Blake.
I don't know what Carly's career high is, but she's got to be approaching it tonight. She's got 19.
Yeah, she's having a really great night, but that's her shots, you know, yeah. That she gets open and she gets the, you know, the free throw elbow or anywhere around there in front of the three, that's her shot.
Inside to Sargent, poked away, Anderson comes away with it, quickly goes to Ross, and she is going to be fouled by Phillips. That'll be her first. You know, as much pressure has been applied by both teams, not a lot of foul trouble. I mean, three fouls for Stansbury here in this quarter and only one against Union.
Yeah, those are the best kind of games when you don't, like, notice the referees.
Exactly. As that's stolen away, it's Warner. Warner is going to be cut off by Miller. She'll now reset the offense. And a little back door to Thurber. Loses it, finally gets it back to Riggle, and Riggle puts the shot up, and it's going to be good. And she will be fouled. So she'll go to the free throw line as we watch here on the L&L Motor replay. And shot is up and in. I think they're going to call that on Ross.
That was a great shot by Riggle, not to take the first shot, but drive it back in to get it closer to the rim. And then get fouled on top of that. Got to make the free throws, though.
Miss there by Riggle. Miller with the ball. She'll go to Anderson way outside. Pressure being applied. I think we're going to have a foul away from the ball on Phillips. As Ross was trying to cut to the basket, Phillips grabbed her. Item will come back in. She will replace Hines. Inbounds pass knocked away. Item comes away with it, and she will drive, put the shot up, no good, and rebounded right there by Anderson. Anderson will go to Ross. 11 seconds to go here in the third quarter, a quick moving third.
And we'll see who gets the last shot here.
I said 11, it was actually 19, but I couldn't see it, so 9 seconds now. And the Lady Cougars will be inbounding under their basket with 9 seconds to go.
Yeah, I like getting a screen here for Kennedy Ross, maybe a three, or maybe a Tori Ross.
Kennedy with the inbound. We're going to have a foul on Warner. Warner's second. 8 seconds now left to go. Inbound to Anderson. Anderson will drive. And that's going to be a travel. Extra step there for Anderson. We'll turn it over with 1.3 seconds to go.
Yeah, they were just trying to get it out there to Anderson at the three-point line so that they could get three-point shooters or someone to even cut.
Stansbury did a nice job of not allowing either Ross girls to get open.
They bottled her up really well, and then she just traveled.
44 for the Lady Cougars, 29 for Stansbury at the end of three. We'll be back after a quick break.
Dr. Carl Breitenbach, Dr. Rod Anderson, Dr. John Griffith, Dr. Daniel Kwok, and Dr. Ethan Pettit, all part of the great team for obstetric and newborn care at Ashley Regional Medical Center. Our obstetric team has over 80 years of combined experience in delivering your baby and working closely with a highly trained team of obstetrical nurses. Our pediatrics team can treat newborns at 34 weeks and older in our Level 2 NICU, providing you with the opportunity to stay close to home with your friends and family to support you. Our new Women's Center, opening in 2018, will provide the latest in amenities for your comfort and quality of care. Worried about costs? Our new Storks program can provide you with the help you may need. You can ask any of our providers for more information. You can trust the care at Ashley Regional for you and your newborn. Ashley Regional, making communities healthier.
All right, we are back. Fourth quarter just getting ready to start. We'd like to thank Moon Lake Electric, power, providing power to the area since 1938, owned and operated by the people they serve. Moon Lake is a cooperative, not privately owned. Find and like them on Facebook. All right. Stansbury with Thurber. She'll go inside to Riggle, and her shot is up and good. Pressure as the Lady Cougars get it in. They'll go to Kennedy Ross, and she's going to try to get it to Torrey, but Phillips comes away with the steal. Now quickly off to Hines. Hines will drive and be fouled from behind by Anderson. See this on the replay. Hines drives, and Anderson just gets her on the arm.
Yeah, that's maybe a possible 4 points in a row here for Stansbury. Could be big in the fourth quarter. They really need a run. Hits Hines the first one.
Free throw is good. She's 4 of 5 from the free throw line tonight. Weaver and Horrocks will come back in. They will replace Kennedy Ross and Anderson. Hines will have one more. It is up and good. So a 4-0 start here to this fourth quarter. Pressure now being applied to Miller. She'll get it to Ross. Ross yo-yoing the dribble out wide. Now goes to Horrocks on the wing. Horrocks will work off a screen. Goes to Weaver. Weaver way outside to Miller. Now to Horrocks. Probably the longest possession the Lady Cougars have had tonight. And Horrocks will drive. She's going to be fouled, so she'll go to the line to shoot a couple.
Yeah, good looking drive there. She just got her on her back heels there and drove it in and had it there. Almost got the on one. She'll go for two, though.
That is 5 on Hines, so Hines will foul out for the Stansbury Stallions. So Horrocks will be at the line to shoot two. Warner checks back in.
And that's one of those 100-point scorers that goes to the bench in that final quarter. It yeah. hurts, but, man, there's a lot more of them yep. out there at least. So
we're going to – I thought we were shooting two. She missed the first. We played it as a 1-1, but she'll have one more.
You know, you can tell Stanberry's a good team. You know, just on the road, it's a little bit different. But, I mean, they won 3 games right in a row, and then they had a real close one with Grantsville the other day, 55-46. And this, sometimes that can hang over that loss to you, where you can either do one or two ways. You can play really good the next game or kind of flat. And it looks like they're a little bit flat out there, especially when they're shooting the ball. But I think the coach has done a great job of getting the interior passing and trying to get shots underneath the hoop instead of outside shots that aren't falling right now.
Warner will inbound. She'll go to Phillips. Phillips kicks it off to Item. Now goes to Riggle. Riggle shot up and good.
That's about the 4th time she's done that shot. It's a good looking little floater almost.
Yeah. They've cut it to a 10-point lead. So a 10-point game as shot there by Horrocks is no good. Rebound by Item. And she'll get it off to Phillips. Pressure being applied, and I'm going to call a foul on Ross.
There's no give up in this Stansbury team. You can see it. they feel that they want to get this within single digits under the five-minute mark, and you're still pretty good, and you're at 6:29. So just keep executing, keep getting shots right underneath the basket, work it around until you get a great shot. So
they've gone on a little bit of a run here as they've cut the 15-point lead to just down to a 10-point lead. Another fine sponsor we'd like to thank is Savage. They're a proud sponsor of VTV's coverage of high school basketball. And don't forget to check out the Sports Spin on VTV 6 Thursdays at 6:30. Mark and John bring you weekly highlights and an analysis from all of your Basin teams. Like the Sports Spin on Twitter and Instagram. So with fourth quarter here, 10-point game. If you're Coach Hoops, are you going to tell your team to kind of slow it down a little bit or to continue to play that fast pace that they've played throughout most of the game?
I think in the last 5 minutes, well, the way they've slowed it down and just tried to get a good shot instead of, like, speeding up and being out of control, I think you slow it down. I think you keep where you're going.
Yes. And you know Stansbury, they're going to want to pressure and do as much as they can. So,
and if you're Union, you want to run as much clock, but then you also have to execute on offense and get a good shot too. You need to stay aggressive, I think, for Union.
It's going to be Thurber working off a screen. Miller cuts her off. Thurber now looks inside to Warner. She's double teamed, but gets it out to Phillips. Phillips being guarded there by Ross. She's able to go to the left-handed dribble and kick it out to Warner, now to Riggle. Riggle runs into Thurber, and we're going to have a travel as she ran into her own player.
That's unfortunate when that happens. A little friendly fire there. Looked like it hurt a little bit, too.
Yeah, it did. Horrocks with the ball, and she's going to be tied up. It's going to be a jump ball. Just quick hands there by Stansbury.
Stays with Union.
Horrocks will get it in to Blake. Now back to Horrocks. Ross in the corner. Ross will drive, put a shot up, and it is good. Tori Ross, her first points here in the second half. Warner works to Thurber. Thurber fires up a three-point shot. It is no good. And we're going to have an over-the-back foul on Riggle. She came over the back of Horrocks.
Yeah, Thurber almost hit that shot, but on the other side, Tori Ross. You know, when you need a big play, you go to Tori Ross because she can get it done for you. I've seen in countless games when they get kind of in trouble or losing the ball or control, you just go to her and she kind of makes the game easier and slows it down.
1-1 for Horrocks. She is 1-for-2 from the line and misses the front end. And it's going to be out of bounds. Saved. And then stolen away by Phillips. Phillips going to continue to work on this right left side. She will now go to Item. Item works off of a screen. We got some contact there. And they're going to call that on Anderson as she ran through the screen.
I think they need to work it and go back down underneath the Riggle. She's been doing really good underneath there. See if they draw a play up for her.
Item will be inbounding. Goes to Riggle out high. Now to Thurber.
I'm a high believer, if it's not broke, don't fix it.
And there it is. Riggle inside. She's able to convert once again. And we're going to have a travel. You know, I don't know if she actually moved that pivot foot, but it really looked like she did. So Stansbury hanging right in there. Just over 5 minutes to go. It is a 10-point game.
I still want to see
inbound.
I still want to see Riggle get the ball and maybe, you know, kick it back out to an open three. You know, you don't want to be too predictable, but
turn it over as they're trying to get it to her that time.
Yeah. She needs to at least touch it.
Long pass to Blake. Blake now goes to Anderson, and she's going to be fouled by Item. We'll see that here on the L&L replay. Anderson catches and contact there, so she'll be shooting a couple.
Yeah, and she gets a little bit older on that play when she gets that ball in there. Instead of taking it up, if she just faked and let the person go right over him, she would get easy too. That just comes with experience, though. She's only is she a sophomore?
I believe so. Yes. But makes the first. She'll be shooting one more.
Got to really like her size and height.
That one's off, no good. And going to be knocked out of bounds. It'll stay with Stansbury. So we're under five to go. Thurber going to bring it across. Now to Riggle. Riggle goes to Item. There's Riggle down low. They'll get her the ball, fired up, and it's good. Cougars have not had really an answer at all for Riggle, especially here in the second half.
And then a pressure right there on the fast break, trying there and get the ball back, yeah.
10 points scored by Riggle here in the second half. All of them virtually from the same spot on the floor.
Yeah, I really like what I see from Riggle, just sealing off her girl there.
Inside, they're trying to get it to Warner, and we're going to have a foul on Horrocks.
So they did what they needed to do. They got it within single digits in that, and they have an opportunity to get back right back in this game.
Horrocks and Miller will go out. Kennedy Ross will come in, and that's number 22.
Oh, another shot there. Underneath 21
for Weaver.
That's Josie Warner. She's had a great game too.
Yep. So Ross will.
A 7-point game.
4 minutes to go. Goes across to, that's Mesa Nilsson. And Nilsson will be fouled, so she'll go to the free throw line.
And these are the times where you really need to hit free throws if you're Union.
Nilsson just into the game, and her first free throw is good.
That's really hard to do. You haven't seen the floor much all game long. Come up and step and hit the first shot at the free throw line.
We're going to take a quick 30-second timeout. Give us an opportunity to thank our fine sponsors. We got L&L Motor, Strata Networks, Ashley Regional, Moon Lake Electric, and Savage. L&L reminds you, it's the love of the game, the players, the competition, and the diehard fans that matter most. Let each mile you drive in your L&L vehicle take you to the moments that matter most in your life. L&L Motor, the sponsor of our replay tonight as well. 8-point game. Nilsson will be on the line to shoot one more. And we're just over 4 minutes and 5 seconds to go in the game. Stallions have done a nice job cutting a 15-point lead down to currently 8. And Lady Cougars looking to make it 9.
You see on the bench, they're all fired up, and they're so happy about this coming back.
That shot was missed. So it's an 8-point game, just under 4 to go. Thurber will go. I believe that's Warner. We're going to have a foul away from the ball. Call that on Blake. Carly Blake.
Yeah, I didn't really see a foul there at all.
I didn't see much either. That'll put that Riggle. That's going to be Riggle at the line. She's 0 for 1 from the free throw line. And misses that one as well. Going to be brought down by Blake. She'll go to Ross. Ross has it knocked away momentarily. She regains control. Goes to Kennedy. Kennedy down inside to Anderson. Works top of the key to Blake. Blake's shot is no good, but Anderson follows. That's a big shot for the Lady
Cougars.
Yeah,
what a rebound by Reagan Anderson.
That is a big shot. And Thurber fires up the shot. She gets her own rebound and throws it over the basket. And she's wanting a foul, as is the coach. That's one thing you can guarantee. People are always going to think they were fouled. And tries to inbound. Thurber knocks it out of bounds.
Good inbounds defense there by Thurber.
They get double team over here on Ross.
They really don't want Ross to have the ball.
Nope. Get it into Blake. Blake's able to cross over her dribble and get down the court. Now she goes to, is that Horrocks? No, that's Nilsson. Nilsson will fire it across to Ross. Ross awfully close to that half court line. She now goes to Nilsson. And Nilsson will finally get it to Ross. Ross goes off of a screen. And she's going to work there. Warner on defense. Ross will fire the shot up. It's down and out. And there's Anderson once again with the rebound. This time the shot no good. Item comes away with the rebound. She will get it off to Warner. Warner gets it inside. Knocked away by Ross and stolen. Yeah. Ross is going to push.
Good double team there by Ross and Carly Blake. Just getting in the way, stealing the ball in a huge moment. 2 minutes and 17 seconds. Trying to close out this game at home.
Thurber with the foul. That's going to put Nilsson at the line to shoot two.
So Stansbury had some runs tonight, but, you know, Union had some answers. Yep. Every time that they would get even close or start a run, Union would have one of their own and or make a big defensive play on the other side. So great job by Union tonight. And credit, you know, Stansbury for coming back and not giving up. And
10-point game with just over two, and there's another offensive rebound. Guess who? Anderson.
Three offensive rebounds in the last 3 minutes for Reagan Anderson.
There's a two-pointer left for Warner.
Then a knockdown shot by Kennedy Ross right there. You can tell the Union wants to win this game for sure.
They're a 10-point game with just over two, 2:03 to go. Strata Networks is proud to help bring you live coverage of local sports. Enjoy reliable coverage and unbeatable speeds from the company that brings you more local cell sites than any other carrier. Nationwide 4G LTE coverage and the latest devices from your favorite brands. Strata Network is proud to be the local wireless provider. Right now, get a 4G smartphone for $0 down, an upgrade in as early as 1 year with a Strata Plus. Learn more at stratanetworks.com. Strata Networks brings you the latest mobile devices from your favorite brands. Visit them today and buy one at Strata Networks. We connect lives. Just under 2 minutes to go. It's a 10-point lead for the Lady Cougars. Stansbury will put pressure on once again. The Cougars have had a little bit of problems here in this fourth quarter with this pressure. Stansbury's been able to force a few turnovers.
Yeah, last time these teams met, it was a close game to the end as well. It was a three-point game at the end, and Union took it. So they're both evenly matched, and it's a great conference matchup.
Thurber fouls Ross. That will be number four on Thurber. And that'll send Tori to the free throw line. She has yet to shoot free throws tonight. She has a three-pointer and a regular basket. And she now has a free throw to go with that. So her first one is good. Extends it to an 11-point lead. And the second one rattles around, and Anderson with the rebound. This time it's no good.
Oh, almost a pickoff pass there. So close.
Yeah. So Sargent will come out, and That's number 14. That is Victoria Fiddler. And Nielsen with a steal and foul.
Yeah, Nielsen coming off the bench and just causing all sorts of problems for Stansbury.
You know, they've got some quickness off there off their bench. They brought Miller in for a while. She did a nice job.
She did a nice job.
Nielsen in here late. She's done a nice job. So.
And I think that's what the coach does really good here. He not only, you know, he's got a young team, but he's cultivating his program going forward, too, to even build more depth. If you have more depth like that, you're unstoppable, especially when it comes to tournament when you're playing back-to-back games. Mm-hmm. Just huge.
Nielsen's free throw is up and good. Now the Cougars going to apply a little pressure just to make them work to get it across. Warner with the ball. She's going to fire it up just out of the free throw line. No good. Ball actually hits the ground. We're going to have a jump ball. It'll be Stansbury ball.
Nielsen in that play again with the tie-up.
Phillips now works for Stansbury. She has it knocked away by Ross. She gets it back, fires it up, and the shot rolls around. Blake with the rebound quickly goes to Ross. And Ross gets by Phillips. She will drive, put the shot up. And no foul. She's able to try and save it, but right to Thurber. Thurber will now drive and throw it to no one. It's going to be a backcourt violation.
I'm just impressed with the hustle on Union. I mean, you're up by,
you know, 12, and
12, and you're still playing as hard as if you were you're losing by two or three. That's, you can't. Sometimes you just can't coach that. That's just
no. That's exactly right. Inside to Anderson. She's going to put up the shot on the baseline and hit it.
Pretty shot. That was a great shot. Just a turnaround fade.
Warner will bring it across as they've extended their lead to 14 now. Warner spins around, gets it to Phillips. Phillips goes to, tries to go to Thurber, and Nielsen's right there with the steal. And then Phillips takes it away and gets it to Thurber. Thurber, long three-pointer off the rim, and Anderson had it, but Thurber pulls it away. Now Anderson knocks it away from her and is going to be called for the foul.
Yeah, a little bit of a, I wouldn't say frustration foul because you're up ahead, but maybe a tired foul.
Yeah.
You don't want to run down the court.
And you might be a little frustrated because it looked like you got hammered a couple times and it didn't get called. So that'll put Thurber at the line. Her one-on-one shot is no good. Blake with the rebound. She'll go to Ross. And Ross going to kick it out. Even down by 14, Stansbury not backing off. They're still playing pressure defense as Kennedy goes to Nielsen. Nielsen will work. And finally, she's going to be fouled. So she'll go back to free throw line.
A really good minutes there by Nielsen at the end of this game. She's just playing with super heart. Yeah. I mean, give her a little bit more playing time.
Yeah.
She's two. She's trying to earn it.
2 of 6 from the free throw line, but she hits that one. Makes it 3 of 7. So with just 5 seconds to go.
And when Stansbury was on a run, she was the one that got hit on the free throw line, and she knocked that first one down. And ever since, she's just been fire.
And she's not laying off either, as time is about to expire, and does. She's still playing hard defense. So your final score, Union 59, Stansbury 43. That means the Lady Cougars will be the number 2 seed out of Region 10. And they will be playing one of the teams from, I believe it's the other region with Juab and Carbon and those guys, I believe is who they match up with. When I looked at the paper today. So, well, a good game, 59-43, your final score. Any final thoughts?
Just, Stansbury, they're a good team. They're going to learn from this. You play on the road, it's a little bit hard. You know, in Union, what a great home win. They won their last game with Grantsville. I mean, they're kind of on a roll right now. Yeah. So, I mean, what a great game to call with Merlin here. And, you know, stay tuned with us for the boys game tonight. It's going to be good, too.
Very good. We'll be back in a little bit for the boys game.